Assalamu alaikum. How are you, dear students? Hope that you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. I am also fine. Dear students, like before, today I have presented in front of you to take another class. I hope you have prepared well to take my class. Please be seated in front of your table. Take your pen and pencil and khata, textbook. Start to write down if you get new informations. Okay. Dear learners, I am Mohammad Mohsin Mia, assistant head teacher, Kheriyar Adarsh High School, Saharasi, Chatpur, is conducting a class with you. Before starting my class, at first I would like to discuss with you what am I going to conduct a class and what will be the topic subject. Okay, now look at the screen. There are two pictures here. Can you guess what about the pictures? Can you tell me what about the pictures are? Yes, I think you are discussing with each other that the first one is a man is keeping the watches in the roads, and the second one is the people are voting for election. Okay, actually both of the words are related to responsibilities. One is a duty or obligation not to do, and another is a duty or obligation to do. Okay, people should not do this type of work and people must do this type of work. So these are called responsibilities. Okay, to do or not to do. Okay, dear learners, today I am going to conduct a class with you. The name of the topic is responsibilities, unit 1, lesson 4, English for today, of class 9 and 10. Please open your book. After the end of the lessons, you will be able to learn your top one's responsibilities, narrate incidents, participate in discussions, listen and understand others, describe something in writing, write an article. What is responsibilities? If I ask you a question, what is responsibilities? Responsibilities is a duty or obligation to do or not to do. As a student, you have responsibility to appear in their examination, and your responsibilities are to listen to your teachers in the class carefully, learn your lessons every day, attend your class regularly in time, and obey the rules and regulation of the schools. Okay, and another picture, you can see that a lady who is sleeping in the office, but it is not, it is also in the offices, in the a lady who is sleeping in the office. Before I discussed with you that responsibilities is a duty or obligation to do or not to do, but it is duty of to do appear in the examination, but it is not duty of to do, it is duty of not to do. Okay, so you will not do this type of work that is not approved by the society or the state or your family or school. Okay, so this is the duty obligation not to do. Okay, we can clearly know that a responsibility is a duty or an obligation to do or not to do something. Dear learners, you are students, so as students you have some responsibilities, you have some duties. Your duties or obligations are to attend the school regularly, listen to your teachers carefully, and if your classroom is dirty, you should clean it carefully. It is also your responsibilities. And maintain the furnitures of the class and take care of the bags of others. That's are your responsibilities. Okay. Now read it. Attending in school regularly, learning lesson, obeying teachers, keeping classroom clean, etc. are the responsibilities of the students. And if you are a wild citizen, you have some responsibilities to your society. Your responsibilities is to help the needy or helpless people in their danger, and you have also have responsibilities to give them some gift or foods during Eid. Okay. And if any canal, if there is any bamboo bridge over the canal, and if it is broken and people cannot go from one place to another, people cannot move because of breaking the bamboo bridge, you have some responsibilities. That's how you should make the bamboo bridge taking help from the society. You should make the bamboo bridge along with your friends. Okay, this is your responsibilities to the society. Okay, dear learners, giving a hand to the society are also another responsibilities as a citizen. Okay. Then another is responsibility to state as a citizen. If you are a voter and your age is 18 or over, you have a responsibility. You should go to the voting center to put your vote. Okay, this is your responsibility to state. Another also, if the road seats uncleaned, you should clean it. And if the trees of the road are broken, you should take care of them, and you should water the plants. This is the responsibilities to state. Okay, obey the rules which is approved by the state are responsibilities to you. Okay. Dear learners, now enjoy a video. Then I shall ask you some questions. Okay.
Rights and responsibilities. As an NLC student, these are your rights. You have the right to fairness, respect, dignity, quality programs and services, safe and healthy learning environment. You have the right to confidentiality, view any official record that exists in your file as per the Freedom of Information and Protection of Privacy legislation, aka FOIL. You have the right to a program handbook or info package, and a course outline. You have the right to regular progress reports posted on the board. Discuss your progress report grades with your instructor. You have the right to receive quick and helpful feedback from the students and examples. All the other mechanisms was watch those pesky riddled sentences for the same venture. You have the right to an advocate who can speak or write on behalf of the students. I got you, Kevin! You have the right to provide feedback to the College of All Programs and Services. The tutoring helped make a huge difference in my grades. The EFT service program part-time has been awesome. You have the right to file complaints about a violation of your rights in the student services procedure. I need answers. I need to make a complaint. You have the right to appeal college decisions to student services procedure. That's why I deserve.
Okay, dear learners, you have already enjoyed a video. Now my question is, right, what rights do you have as a student? Mention two or three things. Number two, whom should you discuss about your progress with? Number three, from where you will get feedback. If you listened and enjoyed the video carefully, I think you will be able to answer the questions, okay? Because these questions are given you from the video, okay? I suggest you should show the video, you should watch the video again, so it will be very easy for you to answer of the questions. Okay, dear learners, now I am discussing with you elaborately responsibilities to public road. Here it is responsibility not to do. Okay, previously we discussed with you what you should to do, and now I am discussing with you what you should not to do. Okay, if there is a foot over the road, you should not cross the road on foot. Okay, so it is not your responsibilities. Your responsibilities is crossing the road over the foot over bridge. Okay, and another is, since you are a good citizens and roads are for the citizens, all types of people go from one place to another through the roads, and cars also ply through the road. So as a citizens, you should not keep any wastes in the road. So it is responsibilities to you not to do. Okay, and another is, you should not drive your car in the wrong side. So it is your responsibilities obeying the traffic rules, and it is also responsibility not to drive the car over speed and disobeying the traffic rules. Okay, and another is, you should have obeying driving rules. If you are motorcycle vehicle driver, or if you are a motorcycle holder, you should wear a helmet and obey the rules when you are driving your motorcycle in the road. Okay, you should use footwear bridge to cross the road, obey traffic rules. You should not keep any wastes in a footpath or public road. Then responsibility to the old and sick. Dear learners, the young people becomes old or sick one day. If there is a sick or old people in your house, as a citizen, as a people, as a man, as a student, you should look after the old and sick people. And if your mother is old and sick, you should look after her carefully. And the same way in your father and the elders. Okay, so you have strong responsibilities to the old and sick. And another is, if any blood is needed for the sick people, you should donate blood. This is your responsibilities. Okay, that means helping the sick is your another types of responsibilities. Okay, you should look after the parents when they are old and help the sick people. Dear learners, now read the passage carefully, then I shall ask you the questions. Actually, at first I am reading the passage. You should listen to me carefully, then I shall ask you the questions. Okay, now I am reading the passages. You listen to me, and you also open your book and read with me. A responsibility is a duty or an obligation to do something. For example, you have the responsibility to take care of your parents in their old age, to attend school and pursue your studies properly, and so on. You have also the responsibility to society and the government, as for example, to help a neighbor in trouble, or to cast your vote if you are 18 or over. A responsibility is also an obligation or a duty not to do something. For example, you have the responsibility not to steal a book from a public library or not to put your building materials on the footpath. These are your responsibilities as citizens, but there are responsibilities of the government as well. Our government has the responsibilities to provide for its citizens the basic necessities of life, including food, clothing, shelter, education, and medical care. The government also has the responsibilities to protect the fundamental rights of its citizens to freedom of speech and expression, freedom of the press, freedom of religion, equality of all before law, etc. The knowledge, skills, and attitudes you have gained at home, at school, and in society will help you to accept your responsibilities and to carry them out effectively. Remember, discharging your responsibilities will be good for you, good for your family and friends, and good for your society and country as a whole. I think you have faced some unknown vocabularies. Now I am solving them. First one is expression. Do you know what is the meaning of expression? Expression, that means feeling. Okay. Expression, that means feeling. An action of showing one's feeling. Can you make a sentence with the word expression? Okay, I think you will be able to make sentence. The expression of the child is thinkable. Okay. Another word, effectively. Now look at the picture. The two work has been done effectively, and another is not. So effectively, okay, that means successfully. Can you make a sentence by the word effectively? Certainly you will be able to make sentence. You have completed your lesson effectively. Okay. And another word is discharge. This is discharge. That means unburdened. Okay. Discharge, that means unburdened. Now make a sentence with the word discharge. Okay. Work sincerely and discharge yourself. Work sincerely and discharge yourself. Okay. Another word, attitude. You can or you can do it, you cannot do it. This is your attitude. Attitude. You have positive attitude and negative attitude. Okay. Suppose a lady is walking through the road and your attitude is she is very fierce woman, or she is very religious woman, or she is very responsible woman. Now it is your attitude. Your attitude may be positive or negative. Okay. Feeling or opinion about something. This is attitude. Now make a sentence. Keeping positive attitude makes oneself perfect. Okay. Dear learners, already I have discussed with you about responsibilities, what you should do or you should not do. That means obligation or duties to do or not to do. Now I am giving here more information about responsibilities. Number one, duty or obligation to do or not to do something. Another is, as a student, you have responsibility, as for example, attending school regularly. As a son, you have responsibility to look after your parents in their old age. And another is, as a neighbor, your responsibility is to keep good relation with your next door people. Okay. As a leader, your responsibility is look after the people of your locality. Then, as a good citizen, your responsibility is to obey the rules of the state. Dear learners, here I have given some information about responsibilities. I think you will make a conversation with your partner about the information. Okay, this will develop your speaking skill, and then you will write what you already have spoken with your partner. Okay, আমি তোমাদেরকে এখানে যে তথ্যগুলো দিয়েছি রেসপন্সিবিলিটি সম্বন্ধে, এগুলো নিয়ে সর্বপ্রথম তুমি তোমার বন্ধুর সাথে ইংরেজি বলবে এই তথ্যগুলোকে ভিত্তি করে। তারপরে তুমি যা বলেছো তোমার বন্ধুর কাছে তা আবার তুমি খাতায় লিখবে, এতে করে তোমার স্পিকিং এবং রাইটিং দুইটি স্কিলই তোমার ডেভেলপ হবে। ওকে ডিয়ার লার্নার্স, নাও আই এম গিভিং ইউ some work instantly you should do it. Here I have given two columns and you should fill the columns with relevant information. In the left side, responsibility is school, and another is responsibilities at home or society. Already I have discussed with you, as a student you have some responsibilities. You know that you have some responsibilities to go to school regularly, learn yourself properly, attend the classes regularly, not to make quarrel with others, obey your teachers, and appear in the examination, etc. There are a lot of responsibilities to your schools. And another is responsibilities at home or society. I have already have discussed with you that in your society you have some responsibilities. They are look after the helpless people or sick people, help the needy or helpless people, and keep good relation with your neighbor, and give well suggestions to your neighbor, and do the public beneficial work, etc. Now dear students, now you try to fill the gaps, then I shall help you. Okay. Dear learners, I hope already you have done it. Since it is online class, so there is no opportunity to check your work instantly. So I believe that you will do your work sincerely and honestly. Now match your answers with mine. Responsibilities at school: attending school regularly, obeying the rules, keeping classroom clean, appearing in the exam, then not to copy in the exam. And there are another lot of responsibilities, but I have only shown you in the a column only 5 points. Okay, and right one: responsibilities at home and society, helping the parents, looking after the youngers, keeping home and yard clean, standing beside the helpless, and last one is settling quarrel. Dear students, as a good citizens, you have a lot of responsibilities to the society and at your home. I think you will perform all of the responsibilities, but only 5 points here I have given. You should write down more and more responsibilities what you have to your society and at your home. Okay, I shall you will do it honestly and sincerely. Okay. Dear students, now I am going to discuss with you about grammar test based on the topic. In the topics, there are a lot of infinitives. So you should find out the infinitives from the passages. Now I am giving a definition of infinitive. Infinitive, that means 2 plus base form of principal verb. This is infinitive. Okay, 2 plus base form of principal verb. This is infinitive. The word 2 plus simple form obey verb equal infinitive. Okay, I hope you have understood. Ami to bangla e bolchi to plus verb er present form ke bola hoy infinitive. Ekhon tumra tomader ei passage er moddhe joto gulo infinitive ache sob gulo khuje ber koro ebong shegulo tumra tomar khatay likho. Okay, here I have given also an example. This is এখানে লেখাটা ভুল হচ্ছে হইছে এটা হবে ইউ হ্যাভ কাম টু হেল্প ইউ হিয়ার টু প্লাস বেস ফ্রম অফ প্রিন্সিপাল বার সো ইট ইজ ইনফিনিটি ওকে নাও দিস ইজ এ টার্ন অফ ইভ্যালুয়েট ইউর সেলস Dear students, here I have given 5 sentences. Now, you try to answer all of the questions and write down in your own khata. Question 1. What will you have to gain in school and at home? What is your responsibilities to the government? What is your right to a school library? What is your responsibility to your parents? Mention your 2 responsibilities to your society. Like before, I am telling you again, you will do this work properly, honestly, and sincerely. Okay? It is one type of exam, one type of examination. Okay? Dear learners, now I am about to end of the class. Now I am giving you homework. Your homework is write an article within 100 words on your responsibilities. I think you will be able to write an article. Okay. I am making it easy as a student, as a citizen, and as a member of the family. What you have responsibilities, what you should do, and what you should not do or what you should not to do, you will write down. It will be a well article. Okay. Ultimately, my suggestion is to you, you will do your homework properly, write down your homework from your own memory. Remember that what you are writing, it is your own asset. If you write anything from any prescribed book or from any sources, it is not your asset. So I again suggest you to write down your article from your own memory, do your homework properly, and she will show your homework to your teachers when your school will be opened. After the end, you stay home in front of your table, engage yourself in studies, and make a friend with your books. Never try to spend or waste your time moving here and there. The next class I shall meet with you with another topics. Thank you very much. See you again. Allah Hafiz.